Hi everyone, back again. It's the 5th of May 2018. I'm just coming to say thank you so much for your prayers for my channel, because I seem to have had a huge answer from the Lord and things seem to be operating pretty well now. So I'm persevering and we'll just hope and pray it stays that way. But thank you so much for your prayers. It's worked amazingly. Within hours of putting that little please pray video up, things were starting to come right. So that's awesome. Now I do have a wee dream to bring you that I had on the 28th of May. I was sleeping and I had this dream just before I awoke, which is usually what happens when the Lord is giving me something. In this dream, I was a carer or a nurse at a hospital, and I was aware of a patient in a room to my left who was very oddly shrouded in a covering of dark cloths over his head. And I was most concerned about that. I just couldn't work out why this would be. And so I went into the room, and as I drew near, I sensed that the man wanted to sit up. So I put my arm behind him and gradually and gently helped him to sit. And as I got him into the seating position, the shrouds on his head lifted away, and I could see a man with a dark beard. He did look to be in his 30s, I would say. He had a dark hair, dark beard, and I think a moustache, just very shortly clipped. Now, I didn't at the time feel any necessary sense that it was Jesus, but I was just concerned about the gentleman. But one thing that I did to this man was I leaned forward to give him a tender kiss on the cheek. Now, I'm not sure why I did that, but I must have felt some form of endearment towards him. And as I did that, as I leaned forward, I saw a very awful, awful wound on his right shoulder. It was a big gaping wound, and at this point my dream ended. Now, for quite a few days I wasn't sure whether this person was a good person or whether the Lord was using it as a warning. But this morning when I prayed about it, the Lord has led me on an amazing pathway of finding information that I never knew existed. And the first thing I found was an article about the saint from the Catholic Church, and I'm not a Catholic, but Padre Pio. Many of you may know of him because he's quite famous for his visions of the 3 days of darkness. But this was all about Padre Pio. He experienced wounds related to the crucifixion of Christ. I am fairly sure, brothers and sisters, he experienced stigmata, which are the wounds on his hands, and the pain that went with that. And as I was reading this article, I realized that not only that, but he also had a terrible pain and wound in his right shoulder. And he said it was far worse than the pain from the stigmata. And I think the best thing is just to let you, if you're interested, to read more about it. But it just made me think about Jesus Christ and what may have happened to his body and his shoulders over that time, and over the time of the crucifixion, that is. Then the Lord led me on an amazing journey through scripture, learning about the shoulders of Jesus Christ, and I would just love to share more on that. Now, just before I go ahead, I just want to show you the article I was looking at. Oh no, this isn't it. Sorry, beg your pardon. Sorry, brothers and sisters. So this is the article about Padre Pio and the shoulder wound of Christ. So just for those that might want to read up on that. And the other one that I showed you was a snapshot of an article about the Shroud of Turin. And that also indicated that on the shroud, whether you believe it is the wrap of Christ or not, we don't really know, but the possibility is that it might be. Also on that shroud, there was indications that the person that had been wrapped in the shroud had taken quite a blow or a wound on the right shoulder. And it talks about the right shoulder showing signs of having been dislocated. So that also is a really interesting article for you to have a look at. Now, of course, during the all the investigations I was doing, one of the first things I wanted to look up was the gospel accounts of Christ carrying the cross. And John 19, 17 is really the only gospel that actually speaks of Jesus carrying it, because many of the other gospels talk about Simon of Cyrene being asked to carry it for Christ. But I think it is fairly well understood that Jesus carried it first, but because of the terrible beating that he was given prior to having to carry the cross, he could not bear the cross. And so they had to find somebody else to carry it the rest of the way. But John 19, 16 and 17, I'll just read to you. So he delivered him to them to be crucified. Now they're talking about Caesar. And so they took Jesus and led him away, and he, bearing his cross, went out to a place called the Place of the Skull, which is called in Hebrew Golgotha, where they crucified him. Now, brothers and sisters, whether you believe that Christ had those wounds on his right shoulder or not, I don't know for sure myself either, but I know that my Lord's body went through so much on that day, and it was all in love for every one of us. And as I thought about that, I did just look at some other scriptures about what those wonderful, loving shoulders do for us, and I'd just like to share those if I may. And the first thing I felt was to share Luke 15, 4 and 5, where it talks about the parable of the man who lost his sheep, the shepherd who lost just one of his flock, and how he went and left the 100 sheep that were still safe. And he goes off and he looks for the lost sheep. And I'll just read those scriptures. So it's Luke 15. I'll start from verse 4. And it says, "What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he loses one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing." And what another beautiful picture that is, isn't it, of Christ's love for us, how he will go out looking for even one who is lost. Any person, he has died on that cross, taken the pain on his body, had the wounds inflicted on him, and then hung on the cross so that we may be saved and our sins might be forgiven. And that parable about the sheep, the little lamb, and how Christ goes off to find it because it was lost, how he is delighted when he finds it. And in verse 6 it says, "And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and neighbors, saying to them, 'Rejoice with me, for I have lost my sheep which was lost.'" And in verse 7 it says, "I say to you that likewise there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than the 99 who persons who needed no repentance." And that's from the King James Bible. The other gorgeous verse I found was in Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 12. And it says, "The beloved of the Lord shall dwell in safety by him, who shelters him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders." Now, I was never aware of that verse until today, but what a gorgeous picture. And that's why I got this lovely painting of the lamb sheltered between the shoulders of the lion. How fabulous. Once again, he who shelters him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders. Deuteronomy 33 verse 12. And just to finish with, I'd like to read Isaiah 9 verses 6 and 7. And it's a well-known verse, of course, but it says, "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder." I don't think I'll go on from that, but because what I'm really dwelling on today is just what the Lord took on upon his shoulders for us because of his great love. He searches for us and he carries the lost back on his shoulders. He took the pain of the cross on his shoulders. He will come back and reign and rule with us, and the government will be upon his shoulders. He has taken so much pain and responsibility and shown so much love on those dear shoulders. So I just thank the Lord for that dream, because it has led me on this journey, and I just pray it will bless you very much. Hope to speak to you again real soon. Bye for now.